Do you want to subscribe to our channel before traveling the mountain of knowledge? Don't forget to click on the bell. Let's start.
Alright, I've got the world in my window for change, and looking at it through the binoculars.
The moon, a loyal companion. It never leaves. It's always there, watching, knowing us in our light and dark moments, changing forever just as we do. Every day it's a different version of itself. Sometimes weak, sometimes strong and full of light. The moon understands what it means to be human. Uncertain, alone, cratered by imperfections. But how did the Queen of Darkness come about? Why is there a satellite of the Earth unlike many other planets? According to information from Apollo Space Research, after the Big Bang, it took another 100 million years for Earth's moon to spring into existence. There are three theories as to how our planet's Koi satellite could have been created: the giant impact hypothesis, the co-formation theory, and the capture theory. Let's start with the co-formation theory. In 2012, researcher Robin Canup of the Southwest Research Institute in Texas proposed that Earth and the Moon formed at the same time when two massive objects five times the size of Mars crashed into each other. Under such an explanation, gravity would have caused material in the early solar system to draw together at the same time as gravity-bound particles together to form Earth. Such a moon would have a very similar composition to the planet and would explain the moon's present location. However, although Earth and the Moon share much of the same material, the Moon is much less dense than our planet, which would likely not be the case if both started with the same heavy elements at their core. The second important hypothesis on this subject is the capture theory. Perhaps Earth's gravity snagged a passing body, as happened with other moons in the solar system, such as the Martian moons of Phobos. Under the capture theory, a rocky body formed elsewhere in the solar system could have been drawn into orbit around Earth. The capture theory would explain the differences in the composition of Earth and its moon. However, such orbiters are often oddly shaped, rather than being spherical bodies like the moon. Their paths don't tend to line up with the ecliptic of their parent planet, also unlike the moon. Let's come to the last one, giant impact hypothesis. Although the co-formation theory and the capture theory both explain some elements of the existence of the moon, they leave many questions unanswered. At present, the giant impact hypothesis seems to cover many of these questions, making it the best model to fit the scientific evidence for how the moon was created. The moon's far side has a crust that is 50 kilometers thicker than that of the near side. This is thought to be because the moon fused from two different bodies. The prevailing theory supported by the scientific community, the giant impact hypothesis, suggests that the moon formed when an object smashed into early Earth. Like the other planets, Earth formed from the leftover cloud of dust and gas orbiting the young sun. The early solar system was a violent place, and a number of bodies were created that never made it to full planetary status. One of these could have crashed into Earth not long after the young planet was created. Known as Theia, the Mars-sized body collided with Earth, throwing vaporized chunks of the young planet's crust into space. Gravity bound the ejected particles together, creating a moon that is the largest in the solar system in relation to its host planet. This sort of formation would explain why the moon is made up predominantly of lighter elements, making it less dense than Earth. The material that formed it came from the crust, while leaving the planet's rocky core untouched. Although this is the most popular theory, it is not without its challenges. This theory has been simulated many times with computer programs. Most models suggest that more than 60% of the moon should be made up of the material from Theia. But rock samples from the Apollo mission suggest otherwise. When the stone samples taken from the moon are examined, the Earth and moon are almost twins. In 2001, a team at the Carnegie Institute of Washington reported the most precise measurement of the isotopic signatures of lunar rocks. The rocks from the Apollo program had the same isotopic signature as rocks from Earth, differing from almost all other bodies in the solar system. This observation was unexpected, because most of the material that formed the moon was thought to come from Theia, and it was announced in 2007 that there was less than a 1% chance that Theia and Earth had identical isotopic signatures. Other Apollo lunar samples had in 2012 the same titanium isotope's composition as Earth, which conflicts with what is expected if the moon formed far from Earth or is derived from Theia. These discrepancies may be explained by variations of the giant impact hypothesis. Put it in a nutshell, during the formation of the Earth, the medium formed the Moon in a similar composition after the collision. The best scientific evidence available shows this. However, one must not forget a margin of error in science. Our next video will be about the start of the Second World War. Why did countries fight tooth and nail for the second time? Stay tuned. The sources of all the information said in this video are given in the description section. Please comment to make corrections or additions. If you still have not subscribed, you can subscribe and like the video. Take care yourself. Ciao, ciao.